Well, welcome back to the slowest growing channel and least watched channel. I'm gonna go ahead and play some Mass Effect. I've played Mass Effect before, at least half of it. I never played the second and third one. So what are we gonna do with some of these games like Mass Effect, you know, some of these others like that, Dead Space, you know, Wild Hearts. Those are gonna be like games we play once in a while, but not all the time. You know, mainly in the late at night on Friday, Saturday, maybe even Sundays. Well, maybe not Wild Hearts. Wild Hearts would be normal. Start new career. New career.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database.
Thank you.
Classified information requested. Establishing secure connection.
Better.
Secure connection confirmed.
I'm just curious. Am I the only person that like Mass Effect Andromeda? You know, I mean, it just took it to a different galaxy and everything. It wasn't too bad. Not the greatest, but was definitely good. I enjoyed it quite a bit. So we can make her name.
Please log in to access your profile. Profile reconstruction complete.
Let's change her name. I don't like Jane. Let's see, we used Emily twice, so. I can't remember how to spell Natalie. I'm so stupid. Shell.
Please log in to access your profile.
Sure.
Profile reconstruction complete.
Earthborn. Oh. Soul survivor. Oh, so we don't.
Identification confirmed.
This is too easy. Auto level up. I don't know what that's about, but we definitely want that on. Definitely want some of these suckers on. I was going to play that Life of P, Lies of P, that a little too much.
Well,
right now.
What about Shepard? Earthborn, but no record of her family.
Doesn't have one. She was raised on the streets, learned to look out for herself.
She saw her whole unit die on a cruise. She could have some serious emotional scars.
Every soldier has scars. Shepard's a survivor.
Is that the kind of person we want protecting the galaxy?
That's the only kind of person who can protect the galaxy.
I'll make the call.
The other guy talking, he sounds remote. 21 foot explored Mars, discovered the remains of an ancient space-faring civilization. The decades that followed, these mysterious artifacts reveal startling new technologies. They have been traveled to the further stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They call it the greatest discovery in human history. This civilization is the galaxy. Call it Mass Effect. I remember that. Barely. It's been years since I played this. Many, many, many moons ago.
Arcturus Prime relays in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander. Thank you. Neptune.
We are connected. Calculating transit mass and destination. The relay is hot, acquiring approach vector. Station
like
secure for transit.
Proteus, something like that. They're like the main bad guy or something. I don't remember. There's just some games I just want to have on for like
board
just
screen.
I don't feel like
approach
playing anything. Usually, generally, games I have already played.
Mm-hmm.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emission sync engaged.
Check.
All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihilus gave
you a compliment. The same about you.
So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, specters are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
That's enough. Your soldiers act like it.
Ooh.
Sorry, Commander.
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihilus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
I'm on my way.
Is it me or does the Captain always sound a little pissed off?
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
He is she. On the Normandy. On the Normandy.
The Captain's waiting for you in the comm room, Commander.
Oh, I'm so stupid.
I'm telling you, I just saw him. He marked pilot. He was on a mission.
He's a Spectre. They're always on a mission.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the Captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down at Engineering. I didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihilus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihilus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
I know what you mean.
Do you have a problem with the Captain?
No, ma'am. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
You're probably
right. You
don't
trust Nihilus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War, lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihilus for that.
No, I guess not. But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board, especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihilus doesn't answer to the Captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihilus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihilus isn't telling us about this mission.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action. I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
Marines are meant to fight. You just fix us up and we're done.
I know how things work, Commander. I've seen my share of combat, but it's foolish to go looking for trouble. You could both take a lesson from the captain. He's not afraid of combat, but he knows the value of restraint, too.
Sorry, Doc, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians are generally well-respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the First Contact War. As for Nihilus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I heard Nihilus once took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself. Man, I can't believe I'm on a mission with an actual Spectre.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the Council races, like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander, you'd make a good Spectre.
I
always get dropped into
either.
Impossible situations, forced to survive unbeatable odds. Just like you on a coup.
I try not to think about a coup.
Sorry, Commander. I didn't mean to offend you. I respect what you did there. We all do.
Let's not dwell on the past, Commander. Was there something else you needed?
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander. Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself on a coup. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
This mission isn't about personal glory, Corporal. We have a job to do. Don't do anything stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'm not gonna screw this up.
I hope not.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
Better not screw this up, boy. Beat your ass.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. People give us a chance to talk.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
I've never been there.
But you know of it. It's become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
If you've got something to say, just say it.
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
Uh-oh. This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I already figured that out.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
What's the payload, Captain?
A research team on Eden Prime. unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years.
That's it?
Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
It never hurts to have a few extra hands on board.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
Yeah, sure. I don't trust that guy. I don't remember. I think he does become a bad guy, doesn't he?
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
Not many could have survived what you went through on Akuz. You showed a remarkable will to live, a particularly useful talent. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
I don't like people making decisions about my future.
This isn't about you, Shepard. Humanity needs this. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society. And without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
Yeah, but they're not...
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
Uh-oh.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
This can't be good. Damn, already. Already attacking.
Get down!
Hey, lady. Don't kill her off.
We are under attack, taking heavy casualties. I repeat, heavy casualties. We can't... get evac. They came out of nowhere. We need...
Ooh, his ass. Oh, damn.
cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. It just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly, without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Damn. A gigantic hand. That can't be good.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihlus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihlus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
Ready and able, sir.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck.
We are approaching drop point two.
Saving content, yay.
Ship perimeter secure, Commander.
This place got hit hard, Commander. Hostiles everywhere.
Damn!
What the hell are these things, though? Whatever that is. How are we supposed to know, Dukio? That was weird.
Not now, Commander.
You're talking to like that, Commander. Oh, he's dead.
Rip right through his shields. We're out of chance.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Is that the way we came? So this is... Those things tore that dude up. Both can be acquired by defeating enemies. Yeah, well.
I've got some burned out buildings here, Shepard. A lot of bodies.
Damn.
I'm gonna check it out. I'll try to catch up with you at the dig site.
Anything if you kill him. Fine, I'll kill him. Damn. Oh, they're eating, huh? Ooh, that has to hurt. Oh, that's the... Never mind. Where's the enemies in? Ah, I see him. What an idiot. I'm so stupid. I didn't think
I was gonna make it. Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, ma'am?
Give me a status report, Williams.
Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Any idea what kind of enemy we're facing?
I think they're Geth.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, ma'am. It's time for payback.
Ah, shoot.
Move out!
I hear that investigate, but whatever, it's too late now. Too late now. Ashley. Definitely want her to have that stuff. Oh, we still have 1 point. Oh, who cares about him? Oh, we can do health. Aw. So we still got one more for this. Anything to shoot. Does anyone see anything to shoot? The dig site?
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here and must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Well, thank you. Damn. Finally. Hope we're going the right way. I saw that guy as a guy impaled.
We thought this world was safe until the Geth showed up.
The Geth. We don't miss anything. I thought I was a woman. I was like, Dookie. I don't know where we're heading, but we're heading somewhere. This is the start, so we might have just went the wrong way and I didn't say nothing. We ought to do something to those two for not telling us. Guess where it's brighter, that's where we have to go, I assume, from baby. But, no. Oh, idiot. Anonymous music? The camera doesn't stay where you want it to stay at, though. Ow, man. Stop freaking itching. You got stamina thingamajig. I want to shoot all of those things, but you know, they might not like that. Asses up. Oh, I see where we were supposed to go. Someone could have said something, man. One of my squad mates could have said something.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush.
Damn.
Guard up.
tore their asses.
Oh, God, they're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
You're asking the wrong person. Turn on to zombies. Damn. I remember this part now. Guess that way they make sure you don't constantly shoot. I want one of these though. I'm sure they're gonna make it harder eventually.
Humans, thank the Maker.
Hurry, close the door maker? Before they come back.
How did you end up in this shed?
We hid here during the attack. They must have come here for the beacon. Luckily, it wasn't here. It was moved to the spaceport earlier this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment. The next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the destroyers. Bringers of darkness. Heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside. Gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Damn. Awaken the beast.
Shut
up.
Unleash
the darkness.
Can we slap this
please.
Dude?
This isn't the time.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape? No hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
I want to say that. I want to
say goodnight, Manuel.
You cannot silence the truth. My voice must be heard.
Oh my God! What did you do?
That might have been a little extreme, Commander.
You can't just go around whacking people in the head.
Just a little bump on the head. Let him sleep it off.
I suppose you're right. By the time he wakes up, the meds will have kicked in.
He don't even care. No consequences. I just knocked his ass out. Nobody cares. I knocked that dude's ass out. She knocked that dude's ass out.
Saren.
Uh-oh.
Nihilus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Ooh, got shim. That ain't good.
What is that? Off in the distance.
It's a ship. Look at the size of it.
Where? Holy that crap. Dougie. I already played a zombie. I gave up flying because that one boss is too difficult. They probably already took the thingamajig.
Commander, it's Nihilus.
Turian? You know him?
He's a Spectre. He was with us on the Normandy.
Something's moving. Over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I'm sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Pal. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihilus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone. If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
You ditch work, then you cower back here and do nothing while the Geth butcher everyone else.
I don't even have a gun. What was I supposed to do? Run out there and die? I couldn't save them. Nobody could. It was horrible.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. One minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform. Thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago. Feels like a whole other life.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Yeah. Ow. Sorry, whoa. What's funny is I see the red thing on there that shows there's an enemy and I didn't even get ready for it.
Yeah.
Ferrari die for me.
Not in the middle of a fight!
What are you talking about, Dookie? Not in the middle of a fight, what, mate? He's pissed.
Set the charges. Destroy the entire colony. Leave no evidence that we were here.
This guy's a douche.
Charges. The Geth must have planted them.
Hurry! We need to find them all and shut them down.
You think? Oh, she's smart. That's one way to disarm. Oh, shiznit, we got 4 minutes. I didn't even realize this was time. That sucks. Ow! Out. See, how am I supposed to know where the next one is? Thank you. Oh, I see. That's the trash thing. There you are.
Not in the middle of a fight!
Shut up. Don't talk to me like that. It's like, yes, my master. What do you want? Ah, you got it.
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up.
Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
Uh-oh. I'd be careful. Told you. At least it kills Helm and not the two women.
No, don't touch it. It's too
damn, that's not good.
We identified the ship that touched down on Eden Prime, the Normandy, a human alliance vessel. It was under the command of Captain Anderson. They managed to save the colony.
And the beacon.
One of the humans may have used it.
He's pissed.
Doctor? Dr. Chakwas. I think she's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Like the morning after shore leave. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
Where's the beacon now? What happened to it?
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. Williams and I had to carry you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
Physically, you're fine. But I detected some unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement. Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death, destruction... Nothing's really clear.
I better add this to my report. It may... Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our exo holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going to be fine.
Glad to hear it. Shepard, I need to speak with you. In private.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess if you need me.
Sounds like that beacon hit you pretty hard, Commander. Are you sure you're okay?
I don't like soldiers dying under my command.
Jenkins wasn't your fault. You did a good job, Shepard.
Did we leave Gunnery Chief Williams back on Eden Prime?
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Elenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
The Geth haven't been outside the Vale in 2 centuries, Commander. Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard. Things look bad. Nihlus is dead. The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
I didn't do anything wrong, Captain. Hopefully the Council can see that.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books. That's not why I'm here. It's Saren, that other Turian. Saren's a specter, one of the best, a living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue specter's trouble. Saren's dangerous, and he hates humans.
Why?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy. A lot of aliens think that way. Most of them don't do anything about it. But Saren has allied himself with the Geth. I don't know how, I don't know why. I only know it had something to do with that beacon. You were there just before that beacon self-destructed. Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
Just before I lost consciousness, I had some kind of vision.
A vision? A vision of what?
I saw synthetics. Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
What are we gonna tell them? I had a bad dream?
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction? Whatever it was. Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation is politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a specter. He can go anywhere, do almost anything. That's why we need the Council on our side.
When have they ever done anything for humanity?
If we expose Saren as a traitor, the Council will revoke his Spectre status. I'll contact the Ambassador and see if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Yeah, I'm sure they're gonna believe you.
Glad to see... Commander, I'm glad to see you're okay. Losing Jenkins was hard on the crew, and I'm glad we didn't lose you, too.
Yeah, I wish I could have done something to save him.
I was there. You did everything right. It was just bad luck.
It's been a hell of a shakedown, Cruz. Our first mission ends with one Spectre killing another. The Citadel Council's not gonna be happy about that. Probably use it to lever more concessions out of the Alliance.
You've got a good grasp of the situation. You a career man?
Yeah, a lot of biotics are. We're not restricted, but we sure don't go undocumented. May as well get a paycheck for it. Besides, my father served. I made him proud when I enlisted. Eventually. But is that why you're here? Because of your family?
I never met my parents. If they wanted to see me, they'd have contacted me after that mess a few years back.
Oh, that's right, a coup. I imagine that bought you any post in the fleet. Word is we're heading for the Citadel, ma'am. Can you, tell me why?
The captain hopes the ambassador can get an audience with the Council. Tell them what Saren's been up to.
Makes sense. They'd probably like to know he's not working for them anymore. Whatever happens, we'll be ready, Commander.
I didn't even see her.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. I appreciate that.
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't shown up.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander.
I didn't even see her until we were talking to the dude. Interesting. Too bad none of us would be alive to see any colonization of any planets or anything. But one second, let me get something dealt with. So far, Mass Effect is a good game. I enjoyed the first time I played it. I didn't get a chance to finish it.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work.
So that's the Citadel, huh?
Flagship of the Citadel fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying you need firepower, too.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
This is an outrage! The Council
would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony?
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of the Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
They don't even care. It's like I thought.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
I'm not gonna sit on my ass just because the Council doesn't want to do anything.
They won't stop Saren, I will.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres.
What the hell?
The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
You and me both. Can't believe we forgot to save. I like how she has her weapon out, but she don't need that out.
Good day, Commander. The human ambassador is up the stairs, first room on the right.
You know who I am?
Yes, I receive reports on all newly arrived dignitaries and notable people.
What is this place?
This is the Presidium. More specifically, you are at the Citadel Embassies. If you have more questions, please access Avena.
What's that?
Oh, Avena is the virtual guide for the Citadel. Feel free to access the terminal yourself.
What's your name? What do you do here?
My name is Sephiria. I'm the administrative assistant for the embassies.
You seem to be distracted.
The embassies are the hub of all Citadel politics. When you represent trillions of citizens, it tends to get a little busy.
I should be going now.
Have a pleasant day.
Well, thank you.
Welcome to the Presidium. Allow me to be your guide. Greetings, and welcome to the Presidium. My name is Avena, and I am pleased to be your virtual guide throughout this level of the Citadel Space Station.
So are you a person or a program?
I am a fully interactive virtual intelligence, programmed to provide spontaneous guidance at predetermined locations of interest throughout this level of the Citadel. I may also be contacted through any of the Presidium VI terminals, should you require assistance.
Give me the tour.
You are standing at Presidium Tourism Terminal 1. On either side of this lobby are the embassies of the various Citadel races, along with CSEC headquarters. On the far end of this level, you can see the Citadel Tower, where the Council meets regularly to discuss matters of interstellar importance.
I want to know more about Citadel security.
Citadel Security serves as law enforcement for all regions of the Citadel, though the majority of officers serve in the wards. Executor Palin, a Turian, is the current head of CSEC, but individuals from virtually every species across Citadel space serve as officers beneath him. If you wish to learn more, Executor Palin's office is located in the CSEC headquarters just across the lobby.
Tell me about the embassies.
Each species in Citadel space important enough to be consulted on matters of galactic politics maintains an embassy on the Presidium. The Volus were the first non-council species to be granted an embassy, roughly 2,384 galactic standard years ago. As Citadel space has expanded, more embassies have been added. The most recently added embassy belongs to your own species, humanity. It was added 19 galactic standard years ago, despite some rather vocal opposition.
Why were people trying to keep my species out?
Some species felt humanity was given preferential treatment. It often takes a century or more before a new species is granted an embassy.
Makes
sense. The Council gave a great deal of thought to this matter. In the end, they decided humanity's impact on Citadel space was significant enough to warrant an embassy.
Do you agree with their decision?
I am not programmed to make that kind of qualified judgment. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations.
How come the Volus were the first species given an embassy?
In the early years following the formation of the Council, the Volus were, apart from the Asari and Salarians, the most populous and widespread species in Citadel space. They established many new colonies and trading outposts, and they petitioned the Council for a greater role in determining interstellar policy. In recognition of their work to expand interstellar trade and establish a standardized galactic economy, the Volus were granted an embassy here on the Citadel.
Do you know anything about Spectres?
The term Spectre is derived from the branch of Special Tactics and Reconnaissance. Each Spectre agent is hand-picked by the Council. Their primary role is preserving galactic stability and resolving volatile situations that cannot be handled through normal political channels. In this role, they are granted extraterritorial rights and jurisdictions. Spectres answer to no law or authority except the Council itself.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and thank you for using Avena. Please enjoy your visit to the Citadel.
Oh, that was... I'm not sure what it wants us to do. Oh, there we go. Citadel Towers. Mass Effect is not too bad. Got a lot further than this the first time I played it. Let's see what these dookies have to say. Does anybody just come through here?
The Council isn't going to ask me any questions, are they?
I doubt it. We've made our reports. Now we just have to trust Ambassador Udina.
No, we don't, sir.
I don't trust them. I know we get some aliens to join our crew eventually.
Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 2. You are standing near the base of the Citadel Tower, one of the Presidium's most recognizable and important structures.
This is what's interesting about this game.
Behind
it doesn't really tell you where to go.
Is the spectacular relay monument, a scale model representation of a Prothean mass relay. To your left is one of the keepers, the enigmatic caretakers of the Citadel, working on a control panel. You may see keepers involved in various tasks throughout all levels of the Citadel. We ask that you do not interfere with them in any way.
Sure.
The keepers are essential to the smooth operation of the Citadel. Obstructing their daily work will result in harsh penalties, including incarceration and rehabilitation.
Tell me more about the Relay Monument.
Discovered by the Asari who first arrived at the Citadel, the Relay Monument is one of the station's most interesting and controversial features. What is the meaning behind this striking piece of art? Is it a tribute to Prothean vanity? A reminder of their conquest of the galaxy through mass relay technology? Or perhaps it is a symbol of unity? A Prothean acknowledgement that the relays would eventually lead other species here to the Citadel. No one can say for sure, making the Relay Monument a favorite topic of discussion among academics and scholars.
Tell me about the Citadel Tower.
Housing both the Council Chambers and Citadel Control, the tower is one of the most important buildings on the station. Access to these areas is restricted to those with the appropriate clearance.
I'd like to hear more about the Council Chambers.
The business of the Council, which often has far-reaching effects on the galactic community, is conducted in a room at the apex of the Citadel Tower. The Council Chambers themselves are truly a magnificent sight to behold. Though few get to experience the view in person. Typically, only the counselors, ambassadors, and high-ranking officials, along with various support staff, are allowed access.
I'm scheduled to have an audience with the Council.
Only a handful of visitors to the Citadel are ever granted that privilege. I would be jealous, but that is outside the scope of my programming.
That's all for now.
Thank you for using Avena. You're welcome. Pleasant day.
Sure. Just mainly just want to explore all this. Oh. He gave himself one of the blue girls. Well, we spoke to one that actually missed it, not locking people. Don't really know too much of where we're supposed to go, to be honest with you.
So, Williams, are you happy you signed on with Commander Shepard?
I'm not sure, Lieutenant. Every time I think I have a handle on things, the universe banks hard to port.
Well, don't let anybody know. A big gun and a confident attitude will get you through a lot in life.
Hear music. Not anymore, though.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a Spectre. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
Doubt it. Maybe they shouldn't give any beings that much power. By any person. So it doesn't give you any real directions of where to go.
Hearing's already started. Come on.
Of course it started already. I've been looking around some signs.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihilus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihilus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
Well, that just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard. The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
You're the one who destroyed the beacon, then you tried to cover it up.
Shift the blame to cover your own failures. Just like Captain Anderson. He's taught you well. But what can you expect from a human?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that! That's not his decision!
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
Saren's hiding behind his position as a Spectre. You need to open your eyes.
What we need is evidence. So far, we've seen nothing.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony? I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
Typical. Predictable.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
We need to deal with Saren ourselves.
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
He sounds familiar, that dude right
Harkin's
there.
Probably getting drunk at Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Killing innocents doesn't end wars. It causes them.
I know how the world works, Commander. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions. But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Sometimes 1,000 people must die so 1,000,000 can live.
But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Our ambassador doesn't seem to get along with the Council.
He's just frustrated. The Council's always preaching that we need to be part of the galactic community. But for them, it's a one-way street. They want us to expand and settle unstable regions like the Skillian Verge and the Attican Traverse. But when we run into trouble, they don't want to help us out. Everyone knows it's only a matter of time until we get a seat on the Council. The Ambassador just thinks it should happen sooner rather than later. And I agree.
You don't think much of Harkin.
The guy joined CSEC about 20 years ago. He's been an embarrassment to our species ever since. Roughing up suspects in custody, Bribery accusations, alcohol and drug use. The embassy used to step in when it got in trouble. But I guess enough was enough.
I want to know more about the Spectres.
They're not your typical government agency. They tend to work alone, behind the scenes. They take care of problems the Council can't. It's not easy preserving peace across an entire galaxy. The Council prefers to use diplomacy and negotiation. But sometimes more extreme measures are needed.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
He's a necessary evil of galactic politics. Buying and selling information is a part of the game. And the Shadow Broker just happens to be the best player on the field. Always sells to the highest bidder. Doesn't get involved in politics, doesn't pick sides. A simple system, but it works. He's not a threat to anyone, not directly. He's just a resource we can use, or she is. Or maybe they are. Nobody really knows.
Tell me about Barla Vaughn.
He specializes in moving large sums of money without leaving a paper trail. A financial genius, doesn't do anything illegal, but he knows all the loopholes.
I bet.
He's got an impressive client list. Ambassadors, diplomats, specters. That's probably why the Shadow Broker uses him.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
Well, thank you. I need money. Not sure what they want us to do, though. At least it allows you to save. That's gonna be it. I'm getting kinda tired, though. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, watch my other videos, check out the Bobby section for those links. Follow me here. YouTube, Twitch,